You know I forgot to record?
Oh, shit. Shit happens.
Well, it is what it is. Moving on. You know, I like to fake shit. You know that. Yo, guys, I basically asked him that a whole question. And then forgot to record it for you guys. I'm so sorry. But it was a good-ass answer, too. So. But it's what it is. One thing about me, my brother knows, I can't fake the funk even if I tried to. So, we're moving on. Alright, my question was just telling him a version of speed dating. He told me his answer, but it was right now. Then he gave me a pretty good scenario of how it used to be back in the day. And I realized it's been happening. It's nothing new. Which does happen a lot right now. Everything just free recycling. Well, fashion. Again.
Music. That shit's crazy now. It's getting scary. I'm not hating on nobody's flow, but at least back in the day, like when
sorry, I'm eating my pee pants, but go on.
At least back when you sample somebody, it was like decades apart. Like, you sampling somebody from like
2000s?
5 years ago? I'm gonna say the 2000s, but like, you know what I'm saying? Like 5 years ago.
That's how it feels, but I know what you're saying, yeah.
That shit's crazy. You know how I feel about that kind of stuff. That hurts my feelings, man.
My brother's favorite track?
No, it's not. Shout out to you, though.
My brother's favorite track? Is that 21 Savage track, Secret. Or is it a little secret? But yeah. I love that song. I think it's so cute, but I know why it hurts your heart. I know you, deep down, you know you have to rate it, but it just hurts your heart for how they're sampling your track. Because the sample on it is his track.
Yeah, listen, Escape. That? No, is that Escape? Yeah, I think it is Escape.
Groupie.
That song is how I. Groupie for who? Escape?
Escape. You love that. Escape? I meant the music wise. I don't mean like.
Whoa.
I almost jumped me. My God.
No, it's not a joking spell, you know? It's a groupie for Escape. That's crazy.
Groupie for anything is crazy.
That is a fact.
Period.
I think that's like a Western thing, you know?
To be a groupie?
Maybe not so much a groupie, but to idolized and like, without even realizing a certain level of celebrity. Like, back in the day when I was a kid, I had like, y'all gonna know exactly how old I am based on this statement. Like, you know what I mean? I had my like, Word Up magazine, mm-hmm. pictures on the wall.
That.
And, like,
yeah.
You know, you get a little older, you got your King Mag or whatever on there, your Source magazine. Like, you never hear about somebody who grew up outside of America or Canada doing that. And if they're out there, I never heard of it. Tell me one.
Like, putting up their posters and like.
Yeah. Not artists.
I'm trying to think about when you used to visit family there, and I. No.
You won't see it. Mm-hmm. They don't. You're not special. I like your song. Done. Versus people up here. I seen some people like the way somebody looks, and because they like the way they look, they like their movies, they like their garbage music, they like. You know what I'm saying?
Hold on, let me turn this down. I think it's a little loud. You can keep talking.
Yeah, they got the attitude off. Like, on a note of that, did you know that? Yeah, I saw this just the other day. I'm probably late to it. You know, I'm not a big social media.
I'm probably late too. I'm on social media.
Yo, you know Steven Seagal used to have a dance hall team back in the day. Steven Seagal
used to have a what?
A dance hall tune back in the day.
Tune.
A song? Yeah.
You never know what people are capable of, I guess.
You gotta hear this shit. I heard it. I was in tears.
Why? Is it not good?
Did you just ask me if it was good?
I said, is it not good?
So that means that there's a possibility that it was good.
Yes. I guess that's a no.
Oh, what you know about that? That's on cue right there. If you knock
that was not on cue.
Yo, if you knock a bell.
Tell me that was on cue.
If you knock a bell on that right now.
Super me.
I was going to do it again, but I missed it. I don't know the words like that.
It is crazy, though. The fact that you actually like a song by Lil Yachty, like that's, I'm amazed.
Is it called In the Zone?
Yeah. I think so. It's trippy. My favorite part is just
take me back home.
That part's hard. Okay. Do you even think dating is possible these days? Or do you feel like people are too much in their ego to even be able to sacrifice enough to date or be in a relationship?
I think that there's so many people out here that there's somebody who feels like how you feel that I'd be looking through. So yeah, I think it's possible to date today.
Mm-hmm.
But it's much easier to get lucky than it is to find somebody nowadays.
I agree with that statement.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, definitely.
So if you find somebody who shares the chemistry and you feel like it's worth something, then I would say that it's worth a try still.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? You're going to have to shoot a lot of bricks. Some people will have to shoot a lot of bricks because their jump three ain't hitting. Some people can naturally just shoot the three and then get lucky first jump.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I think it's possible.
I think yes and no. Which is pretty much yes. Mm-hmm. So this doesn't matter anyway. But the only reason why I say no is because people just don't put in the same amount of effort like they used to. I feel like back in the day, like our grandparents and like our parents, they had a lot more patience in their relationships than we do now. And sometimes you may look back at it as a negative thing, but I feel like now with our generations, especially mine in particular, we don't have that patience anymore. It's like a month goes by, or you're pissing me off, goodbye. Like, they don't have that patience of like understanding how to communicate or to talk something out or figure it out. Do you get what I mean?
Mm. Yeah, because it's not back in the day, it used to be applauded. You stand thinking, more words mean something, you know what I mean? Mm. If I say I do,
mm-hmm.
I do.
I actually do.
You
yeah.
understand what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. If people stuck through some shit that I'm not saying that they should have.
Yeah.
But I appreciate the fact that they were able to get past that and be 60, 50, how many years married.
Later.
Married.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So that's crazy. They're happy. They have their kids. They have their grandkids. When you see them, it's not like a show.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
So, yeah, exactly. It's like genuine.
Yeah.
You
know, you can say something without hurting somebody's feelings because I spent how many decades with you?
Yeah.
You know,
like, okay, whatever.
Yeah, that's right, why
honey.
You perform.
Yeah.
You know what it is from what isn't.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, something as small as that, shut up, yo, shut up. Right? Someone from the outside looking in, if they're like really sensitive and new school, you shouldn't talk to me like that. You shouldn't say that.
Yeah.
But between him and his wife, they know that it's like...
That's true.
We're just joking. We're just talking. It's not right. Like...
Yo, babe, what's your favorite food? This is so random.
Curry goat.
Curry goat?
Curry goat. Yeah.
Out of all your favorite... You're so friggin' Jamaican. Out of all your favorite... You weren't even born there. Out of all your favorite...
Curry goat.
Food in the world. Curry goat.
So what I said.
You know, no, let me not even talk, because mine's like pasta.
I had the most boring fucking answer anybody's in the world.
I know, that's why I said, let me just check myself real quick, because what's mine? Like, no, yours is even worse. Yeah. Curry goat is just meh. You know what? I don't really care about curry goat, that's why.
Curry goat is just what?
I rather prefer like a jerk chicken.
That's cool. Jerk chicken is nice too. It's not fucking with goat though. Like,
goat is a different kind of. What is she chewing on? Can you see? Is it a sock?
Yep.
Lola Bean.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, guys.
Holy shit, I had a sock too.
Oh, what's with you?
Why are they in this? What is this?
That's why I asked you to mess with these.
Why are they not in the gold package?
Why are you such a hater?
What is the. What?
Guys.
Why is it not in the gold pack? Milk chocolate?
So I asked you if you messed with this. It's surrounded in milk chocolate and the workers inside.
I'm so
offended
right now.
Oh my god. He's so stubborn. Try new things.
So
put it in your mouth, but you gotta try it.
Chocolate, there's no stamping or nothing, like.
I suck off chocolate and I need the word was after.
Nah, yo. You know what's messed up about it?
It's still there.
You know what's messed up about it?
Mm-mm.
You cut to the texture of it?
Okay. Oh, I'm literally thrown up. Okay, go on.
It's like, even if you don't like it, you gotta suffer through it, you know, because you can't just eat it quick. Like, you have to keep chewing it, you know what I'm saying? And every chew is like more and more of the chocolate mixed with it.
I don't like it.
When you think Werther's, you don't think
chew. Like, totally, don't eat it like that. Like, right now, I'm just eating Werther's.
Nah, man, they could have left that at the factory store. That was, you know.
No, the disrespect, Carly.
If it ain't better than the original, why do it? I feel like that about remixes and stuff like that. Like, or even redos of movies, shit, even video games.
Yeah.
If cozy sneakers. If you're not going to make it the same way you made it back in the day, why are you reintroducing it or putting it under the name or the banner of that thing?
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
You're going to tell me these are the OGJs, but the leather's all fucked up. This is some weird synthetic suede and the stitching and the shape of the shoe is all weird. Like, it's just the same color shoe.
Right.
It's not the same thing from before it used to be, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm not gonna jump in on a. I'm not gonna say let me do the remix to Thriller because I know there's nothing I do
that's gonna top
that could ever top Thriller. You understand what I'm saying?
But whenever you sample, aren't you not supposed to be topping? Aren't you supposed to be paying respect anyway?
Some people don't know who the fuck they're sampling. They ain't paying respect.
Really?
That's the way it sounds.
All right, so like, go
it's
to
the producer.
Research.
It's the producer who's the one who does the research or locks up or somebody puts a mouth on a trail and this is this sampler, this song, and it makes it out of something, right?
Mm-hmm.
Or a team of people come together, right?
Mm-hmm.
But you have to know your shit. How else are you going to find that one obscure sample that nobody knows and then twist it around to make it something else? Like, no disrespect, he's made a lot of hits and he's a legend. I'm not even disrespecting.
Right.
I'm fucking my
right.
Puff Daddy, for example.
Mm-hmm.
You understand what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
He kind of just takes a big sample and just loops it, puts a beat over it. You know what it is. Well, he's got his catalog of artists who are just legendary that make the songs.
Yeah, definitely Carrie. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Versus like a Mad Lib or a Doom or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? They find that odd sample that.
Mm-hmm.
Unless you're a nerd or you happen to be from a family of musicians or something like that.
Yeah, I don't know.
You don't know, you just know you love that sound.
Yep, literally. Okay. You think if the world was all just women, it would be okay? Compared to if it was just all men? Do you have one idea if it was just all men, it would be war?
If it was all men, do I think the world would be war?
Mm-hmm.
Honestly, no. I think that most...
If it was all women?
War, yes, there would be war.
You think if it was all women, think the world was just women, there'd be war?
I think there'd be more of a high percentage for war with women still.
Compared to the men with beer testosterone.
I'll tell
and
you what.
Nowhere to release. Okay.
See, okay. I don't even, you know what's messed up? Because I can only think of the thing for the type of man that I've grown up around. And
that's
I,
what you're I'm, thinking of, but yeah, the I world. Can't think about,
because my automatic answer is men would be cool because there's no women, there's nothing to fight over. Everybody, men for the most part, I'm not fighting over no woman, but from what I've seen in history, in my culture, in my area, and outside my culture, mm-hmm. and outside my area, a lot of men fight for excess mm-hmm. to have power, to be able to have
women.
You understand?
Or a specific caliber. Of
you understand women. What I'm saying? The money's yeah. great and everything like that, but it's what happens if you don't. There's a very few people who are stout and financially sound that have a mm-hmm. goal to be able to be like, the goal is the goal. But most right. people want to be famous or successful to do what they want and be who they want. And that comes with having their selection of the type of woman they want to talk to.
Right? Sure. I think it's both ways. I think it'd be war if it was all women. Or if it was all men, just because it's just freaking human nature.
Okay, let me ask you this. I'm gonna remix your question.
Mm-hmm. Remix?
10 men in the room, all men. Mm-hmm. You understand what I'm saying?
Okay.
Do you think there can be peace in that room?
Yeah, that's a possibility.
10 women
no.
in that same space.
No.
Do you think there can be peace in no. that room? That's all I'm saying.
But it's more than 10 is what I'm saying. It's a different scenario. In that scenario, definitely only the women. The men would just, they're cool. They're chilling. Or if they don't mess with her, they don't mess with her. They know how to be copacetic. The women, two and a quarter chat about this one. It's just, I don't even know what we're arguing about. Then there's the rest of us that are just sitting here cool and eating our food. We don't even know what's going on.
But here's the thing. Like, it's not like I'm like on some misogynistic thing. Out of the 10, I feel like 8 of y'all straight. Cool. 8. Solid 8.
6.
Same thing with men.
6.
8. Cool.
Mm-hmm.
2, for whatever reason, don't like each other.
Yeah.
For whatever reason.
Yeah.
You understand? And they don't like the way you dress. You look like somebody that they had a problem with before. Mm-hmm. They're intimidated. Whatever.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? I feel like out of those 2, two guys would be like, yo, you know what? Yeah, fuck what he's talking about. I'm gonna do my thing.
Right.
I'm gonna keep my eye out.
Mm-hmm. But
understand
I'm gonna
be what I'm saying and come correct, but I don't have to fuck with you and be at the function.
Right.
I can't see two young ladies who have a problem being able to do that and be stuck in the same place for a very long period of time. Unless it's
How long was it for money. How long is it?
Unless it's business. No,
how long
business.
For it is. How long for a period of time how long is this period of time? Are you saying for a long period of time that they couldn't do? The two girls that can't stand each other in the small plate in the one spot. How long is a long time?
We'll treat it like a quarter of a work shift, so 2 hours.
But of course they can do that. 2 hours is it. There's girls that just pop off, like kick off like instantly, and then there's a majority of women who have their head together and understand that's not the way to go. And it's a buildup, like it will get there. There's someone who can take things for like hours of a girl talking about her and being loud and brushing her as she's walking by. And right? Some women can have that no problem, right? And then there's others that you brush her once and it's done, right? Mm-hmm. Party's over.
That's both ways.
As I'm saying. So like,
it's both ways. Obviously it's both ways. I'm just saying I think there's a higher percentage. That's why I said
beginning. Okay, definitely a higher percentage for women. Okay, that I agree. And that way if we address it that way, yes. I know the ladies hate me right now.
I love ladies. I'm not trying to be disrespectful.
It's just facts.
Okay. I look at it.
Before, facts are like, facts. Here's what it is.
You don't like this, man. No.
It's that simple. You go outside, you're walking your dog, for example.
Walking a dog.
Let me just tell the damn story, okay? This is what happened. I went for a walk with my dog today.
Mm-hmm.
Usual walk. And I got to the stop sign. And let me just say this, okay? For those people who drive those big ass 4x4 pickups, if you can't drive your big ass pickup, don't purchase the damn pickup. Do you understand what I'm saying? Because, no, let me tell you why. I'm not even being just ignorant. Let me tell you why. I'm at the four-way stop. It's a four-way stop. Okay. Boom, 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 boom. Okay? Okay. He comes here. By the plaza over here. Like, there's a plaza across over here. Where I have the convenience store.
Okay.
Okay.
Gotcha.
I'm here at the stop sign with the dog. Me and Lolo go to start walking because he stops. And it's not even his turn to go. Fork way. Right?
Okay.
So the car is supposed to go. So that car starts moving, right? And I start walking with Lola. As this car starts moving, all of a sudden he brakes. As I'm looking at him to brake, I realize this guy is driving. He like can't see us. So I like grab Lola and jump back like this, right? And we come back. Okay. Then he drives. Now you know your sister, right? God has to forgive me. You guys, you shouldn't do these things. Okay. So at first, I was like, hey, I'm just gonna cross the street, like, that's fine, right? But I was like, no, that was, like, really bad. Like, you really need to, like, he almost hit me, right? So I walked over with the dog, right? I know.
That was very white.
I know, it was very white girlish. I had a white girl moment, okay? I walked over with the dog, and he was, like, reverse parking, and his blaring music all loud, he turned it down, and I was like, hey! Like a real Karen, right? I was like, hey! Listen, let me just tell you guys something. When you become a dog mommy or daddy, or you become a dog owner, you don't realize how like emotional you get about your dog. Like, the fact that he almost hit her, I was so angry, okay? So anyways, I get over there like a real Karen, and I'm like, hey. And he like turns on his music, and I'm like, what are you doing? You almost hit me and my dog at the four-way. And he's like, oh, I'm sorry, I didn't see you guys. And I was like, yeah, but I had to put my dog back. And he was like, okay, I'm sorry. And I was like, okay. And I just walked away with the dog.
You're lucky you got a guy who was just like, what the fuck are you talking about?
I know, like, who did I think I was?
Somebody be like, listen, you
with my dog, like.
The right person to be like, listen, fuck you and your bully. And then if you and Fido don't get the fuck up out of here, you know?
I said Fido.
Come up to my
you
church.
Say Fido?
Come up to my church.
Oh, you know. Oh my gosh. He said Fido. So upset. She is not a Fido. Oh, because of her pattern?
Say because she's a dog, you know?
Oh. So mad. I was so mad, y'all. Anyways. I didn't know who I thought I was. I guess that was a dummy of the day moment that I have. Actually, was that today? That was today. Sometimes, guys, even as like an adult, you're about to say, your emotions will be at the best of you. But that's where the adult in you has to check yourself and catch yourself and be like, that was a dumb thing to do. Or you need to apologize, or whatever that is. And you have to be man or woman enough to do that.
Sure,
it is a lot easier said than done.
Super fact.
And just know that when you do something, you're asked to take accountability too. You can't act like you didn't do that. And you also can't act like, or what's the word, gaslight, and act like that the person did you dirty when you know you actually did something dirty. So I know that's a thing.
What is a thing?
Gaslighting.
I've heard this term, but I don't know what the fuck it is.
I just think I knew what it meant, and then I really don't know what it meant. Basically, like, I'm mad at you because you did something to me that you actually did something wrong to me. But instead, I'm going to flip it on you and talk to people and tell people about how you did me wrong. Because you're taking it out. Okay.
I have to talk to other people.
I'm mad. No, just in general. Even to me, you can do it. Just back and forth with me talking. So I can be like, you could have punched me in the arm, for example, right? I'm like, ow. Like, no, I'm done with this because you punched me in the arm. And you're going to be like, no, you're not leaving. It's your fault that I had to punch you in the arm because you said blah, like that.
Okay.
That's considered gaslighting. Like flipping it back on the person that they're the problem for why they got hurt, or they're the problem for why you did something to them. Like you deliberately did this to someone, and you know that you did.
I'm trying to find. I know a lot of words in our high vocabulary. I'm trying to find a way to say this other than it's like bitch ass.
I knew.
You know what I'm saying? Like, behavior and tendency, like, you know, like that kind of guy kind of thing. Like,
yeah.
So what's the girl version of gaslighting?
The same thing, all the way around.
Give me an example. Like, I can understand that one.
Cheating. Same scenario, but cheating.
Ah, okay. That's never happened before, so I can't even relate to that. Like, that.
I have been gaslit before.
That exact.
Not with cheating, though.
Mm-hmm. It's my fault.
No.
That's crazy.
I never got that before. Not with cheating, though.
If anybody got that out, they were super discreet, so yeah, I appreciate you for that. Yeah, do your thing, still. Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah.
Fair enough. Alright, yeah. Y'all. Did you have more to say?
For that topic?
Anything in general.
Nothing comes to mind.
You know what I'm saying? That's why I felt it
was like,
as I was closing out.
I'm so crushed by that word that you have no idea still.
This word, there's just...
The only hybrids I want to see are candies. You understand what I'm saying? I don't want to see no hybrid.
It shampoo. Is a candy. It's under the candy umbrella.
Not anymore. No.
Yeah.
That is a chocolate.
Comment down below, because I like mints. And mints are candies. And you tell me mints are not candies. Mints are under the umbrella of candy.
So gum is candy?
No, gum is gum. Y'all, help me out. Tell me, am I tripping? Alright, y'all. Anyways, this was Mellow and Tony Welfare Chronicles from Mellow's Kitchen, because it's just what it is today. And this is your girl Mellow and
Tony.
Oh! High five! I'm like the only person I can get you to do high fives, so. Alright, guys. Bye.
Shit happens.
Oh, it is what it is.